Hey, what is going on, everyone? It's me, Mr. Mario, and in this video, I'm going to be showing you all how you can successfully take any of your PS2 games in ISO format, at least the ones that will work, because backwards compatibility can be iffy with certain games. But I'm going to be showing you all how you can take your PS2 games, encrypt them, install them, and play them on your modified PS3, which has been modified with PS3 HIN. Now, there's a few things I want to address before we really get into this tutorial. First of all, this is going to be specifically for PS3 HIN users, and I'm making this specific video because I have made several videos prior about jailbroken PS3s and running PlayStation 2 ISOs. However, the methods that I've covered prior to this video will not work on a PS3 HIN system. The reason being is that if you are playing a PlayStation 2 ISO on a PS3 using PS3 HIN, it has to be an encrypted ISO. And with this method here, we're going to be taking an ISO, we're going to encrypt it, create an installable package out of it, and then install it just like anything else right here. So the reason why I'm also going to be going about it with this method is because I would rather have it installed on here. This is my preferred method of doing so. Plus, you cannot play your PS2 games directly off of a USB drive. Unfortunately, it is a limitation of the PlayStation 2 emulator on PS3. You can transfer PS2 games from a USB drive, you can install them from a USB drive, but you will not be able to play PS2 games from your USB drive. So be sure for any PS2 games you want to play, you have enough internal storage on your system. So for some prerequisites, of course this is going to require your PS3, which has been modified with PS3 HIN. It's going to require a USB drive or some other method of transferring the games over to the console. We're also going to need a Windows-based PC for an application we're going to be using, and of course your PS2 games that you have backed up. I have a few that I've backed up on my own, and I have videos covering that easily enough, but it's going to be covering that. The last thing you're going to need on here is you will need to make sure your PlayStation 3 running PS3 HIN has been PlayStation Network activated, because we are going to be making use of the on-the-fly licensing, which is required on here, because we're going to be taking an installable package file and it's going to have an EDAT license. So if you have already activated your PS3, like through PlayStation Network and such, in a previous video that I showed on how to use on-the-fly licensing for package file installations, you should be good on here. If you do not have your system activated on a PlayStation Network account, you will get a copyright notice error when you try and install and run these package files. So let's go ahead and move over to our PC and grab a game, encrypt it, create a package file, and come back to the PS3. So over at your PC, there's only going to be one download you'll necessarily need, because this is going to be for an all-in-one application that I really like using here. This is PS2 Classics GUI, and this is a Windows-based tool, so you will need to run this on Windows here. But there's going to be a download link to the psxplace.com download down below in the description. You simply click on download now and you'll be able to download it from here. Next up, just to keep this in mind, I'm also going to link the PlayStation 2 Classics emulator compatibility list. This is an excellent resource which shows a list of a ton of games, which version of the game is available, some notes, and how playable these might be. So it is worth noting that there's some games that work just fine on the PS2 emulator. Some of them are going to be unplayable. Some of them will have, you know, minor issues, major issues, as you can see right here. So you might want to check the game that you're going to be playing to see which one it will be. So for example, I'm going to use Grand Theft Auto. Let me look for it here. So here we go. I'm going to use Liberty City Stories, and I'm going to use the US version. So it says there's been a PS2 Classics release, and it says here, official PS2 Classic. When played out of ISO, it runs poorly and crashes the console, becoming unplayable. So those are just notes to have on hand. I've done the first mission on this game and I know it works fine, so just for testing purposes, I'm not too worried about the longevity of it here, but just keep that in mind. You might want to look up your game before you go through this process. Alright, so right here I have my game that I've already dumped in ISO format, and I have the PS2 Classics GUI. It is a RAR file, so you'll just need to right click it and use something such as WinRAR or 7-zip to extract it into its own folder. And once it's done extracting, you can come in here and navigate down to the PS2 Classics GUI and double click this exe. So this is how the tool looks. You really don't need to modify all that much on here, but I would recommend going into options. And here I'm going to select manual mode and ask where to save the output file. These are just going to be the options I recommend by default. I believe it goes to package, but I'm going to recommend just doing manual here. And you know, that's about it. I've disabled these two and my output path I'm fine with, although it's going to be manual. So you can go back and here just click on this folder button to find where your ISO is located and load it up. So the game should automatically recognize here. Don't touch any of this stuff. All of these options are going to automatically get set up and you do not need to touch them. So next we need to encrypt this by hitting the encrypt button. It's going to ask if you want to patch the LIMG segment with the current image size, say yes, and this will take a few moments here to encrypt your ISO. Once this has been created, just pick where you want to save this, and we're probably going to have to rename this file because it's kind of a mess of a file name here, but go ahead and save it somewhere. So now that's all finished. Go ahead and find where this is saved, and as you can see, this is how it looks, but it's not supposed to look like that by default here, so you will need to rename this. And if you're running Windows and you don't see the full file name, you can go to View and Enable File Name Extensions. So just make sure you have that ticked and enabled. But this needs to be exactly iso.bin.enc. It needs to look exactly like that. All right, so of course we have the encrypted ISO, but now we need to create a package file. So for this, you can just click on Make PKG. And right here, it should automatically populate your game name from the last game that was used. But you can also click on either of these two images, the icon or the background image, to replace them, which for the sake of this, I'm going to do. So I'm just going to click on the icon here and grab my image. So it loads it up there. And do the same thing with the background. There we go, just something like that is fine. So once you have this the exact way you want it set up, you can click on Make PKG, and it's now going to ask you for the iso.bin.enc file, and this is exactly why I had you all rename this, because with its previous broken name or kind of double name on there, you would not be able to find it. But this is exactly what we're looking for. So grab this. Now it should automatically bring you to a configuration page, and it should auto-populate for the game that you are loading up here. Just in case it doesn't, do not change the file name, but this would be within the PS2 Classics GUI folder, configs, GX, and then when you're here, don't change the file name, just click on open. And it's now going to begin creating the package file. Once we have this all set up, just go ahead, wait, let it do its thing. Don't touch this. This is going to take a few more minutes. Alright, so once that finishes up here, you can just click on OK and exit out of this. Now, as you can see, back in the folder where the encrypted ISO is, you should also have a matching package file, which if left by default, should look a little something like that. So now we just have to go through the process of installing the package file, which is just going to be like anything else. Now, if you're going to use this method here, I'm not going to go in all too much detail, but it would be recommended to have a USB drive formatted to FAT32. Then just copy out your package file, go to the root of your USB drive, and paste it in. Now, if you have a PS2 game which is larger than 4 GB, it's of course not going to copy into a FAT32 formatted USB drive, so you'll either have to FTP that file over to your PS3 using your network, or if you check out my NTFS and XFAT tutorial for USB drives, you can actually see that way how you can install games from a USB drive that are over 4 GB in size. Alright, so once this package file finishes copying over, it should be ready for installation, and once that's done, you can just go here, right click, eject your USB drive, and then take it over to your PS3. Over at your PS3, make sure you enable HIN if you have not already. So we're just going to do this here. And again, we are also going to need to make sure that the console is activated. So I know mine has, for example, because I have installed packages like this with no issue. But if you haven't, you will need to go over, sign in or make a PlayStation Network account and activate this system as your primary system for games. So either way, once we're now here and HIN is activated, you can go to your package manager, install standard, and our package is right there. So just like any other package file, it is going to take a few moments here to install. So this is going to be the longest part, just wait here. All right, so once the game is finished installing, we can go back and check it out. Your customized game, if you chose to customize it, should load up here just fine. So it has been installed just like anything else right here. And if we check the information, yeah, that's all we need to know on this. So let's go ahead and run this. If it gives you a copyright error of some kind, that means your system has not been activated. So as one last reminder, you will need to activate your system to enable on-the-fly licensing. But the way it works is once everything is in place, you simply boot up the game and it should work. So as is typical with a PS2 game, once launched on here, our controller will disconnect. So we just need to make sure that's connected here yet again. And as you can see, it's launching just fine. And if you even want to go in here, go into other settings and tweak these, like for example, I'm gonna do full screen, I'm going to enable smoothing, just cause that's how I like to play these games here. You're welcome to do that. So let's go ahead and get in game and make sure this is working just fine. All right, so as you can see, we are in game here working just fine. Well, about as well as it can for a PS2 game. One of the common complaints I do hear with people trying these out is, well, my game is running slow or the performance isn't the best, what's going on? Part of that is just PS2 games being like that. And part of it is also the emulator, depending on what it might be. So it could certainly be the game, it could certainly be the emulator, it could be both, it could be none, it depends on what it is. But I guess what I'm saying here is don't expect complete perfection on here. A lot of PS2 games, even back in the day, if you play them on original hardware now, are still going to have performance issues just because of how they are. So the emulator would technically be accurate in that sense. All right, so there we go. We passed our first mission. Everything still seems to be working fine. So I'm just going to save here in a moment to show you all that saving works just fine. So we don't have to create any of the internal memory cards because this is a PS2 Classics package file, and saving is going to just be created in its own save file. All right, so as you can see here, I can save my game, select a save file. It already finds a memory card that's been emulated on here, and we're good at that point. So congratulations, everything is set up just fine. So we can hit OK here. I can even go back, go into load game, and our save was just created there, so saving is no issue. So let's say we're finished playing our game, you can just press the PlayStation button, quit, and say yes. Just as a reminder, whenever your system is entering and exiting the PlayStation 2 emulator, it is technically doing a soft reboot of sorts, meaning that you are going to be in a stock state and you will need to re-enable HIN when you restart back to the XMB here. If you want to do anything like open up your files, open up any homebrew, install more packages, do any of that stuff. So you will need to re-enable that every time you exit out of a PS2 game. But yeah, that is about it. As you can see, we were able to take this game, encrypt it, create a package file out of it, and install it, and then play it with no issue. Now, I do hope this video has helped out people who have been confused and weren't sure how to run PlayStation 2 games on PS3 HIN. Again, the games have to be encrypted. You cannot just take an ISO and put it on here and load it up through like Webman Games or something. It's not going to work. They have to be encrypted, and part of that is they will also need to be installed if you choose to use this method, such as this. Anyways, this is Mr. Mario signing off. Thank you all for watching, everyone. If you enjoyed this video, a like would absolutely be appreciated, and if you did not like it, a dislike is fine as well too.